Ladies and gentlemen, we'll call the Tuesday, January 10th, public hearing ready, regular city council meeting to order. At this time, I would invite any guests that wish to participate in the invocation to rise, followed by the pledge of allegiance. Councilman Wilson, would you be so kind as to lead our invocation this evening?
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come again just for a certain time. We come again, Heavenly Father, asking you to come down with us as we start a new year. We pray for all mankind, we have any may be, and ask that you continue to bless this city, bless this council, and bless everyone that's in the administration department. We pray for all mankind, wherever they may be, Heavenly Father, and ask that you continue to watch over us and keep us in your care. We give you all the honor and all the praise. Bless and ask in your name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
May you please be seated. Okay, this time the chair will entertain a motion to waive the reading of and approve the minutes of December 13, 2016, regular city council meeting, and the December 20, 2016, special city council meeting. Is there a motion?
Move.
Is there any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay. They stand approved. Item four on our agenda, recognition of new hires and promotions. Chief Burr, anything for you this evening?
Mine showed up.
Madam Manager, anything for you?
Chief Thompson.
Oh, Chief Thompson. I didn't see you back there, sir.
Brenda also has a new hire.
Oh, by all means, ladies first.
Yes.
Mary Catherine?
Oh, do you want to?
Why don't I just heard somebody say Mary Catherine?
Small distance. Okay. This is Ms. Jessica Lynch. She is our new codes enforcement officer.
Ah.
Cannot be more excited. We had some great candidates who applied, but Jessica just has an amazing personality, as you will quickly come to see. And you know that's a tough position, that's a thankless position, so you gotta be a special kind of somebody to do it and do it well. And she's done an amazing job. You've been here how long? 2 weeks? A week? 2 weeks? And we've got a long list. We've had a growing pile of stuff that she'll be tackling, and she's done it all so gracefully and with a smile, with that awesome smile.
Your job and the mayor pro tem job, two jobs I wish I never had that.
We stole her from the medical field and from Florence, so she wasn't with the city of Florence.
Yes,
the
law is speaking.
So we're glad to finally meet you. We have heard a lot about you. We heard that in your initial ride around, I don't even know if you were hired yet or not, but you were pointing out infractions as you were getting away out of town, so.
She put David and I to shame.
Well, so we're delighted to have you as a part of our team. The job that you do is absolutely thankless, but it is probably the most critical to improving our city. You know, the things that you're gonna do are going to really start to show. So thank you for the hard work that you're going to put in.
And we appreciate y'all's patience, because as you know, there is a learning curve, and you may get some angry phone calls while she's out doing her job. So thank you in advance for your support. And thank you, Brenda's here, Karina is off at training, but they've both done a really good job of taking her under their wing and training her so far. So thanks to everybody.
Welcome.
Thank you so much. You're on
power. I know, because I asked, when Brenda told me, she said, we really like this one person. I said, what's his name? Her name.
That's my name.
All right.
That's going to make the difference.
I like that. Okay, anybody else?
Better humorous, you know that.
Chief Thompson.
Yes, sir.
Chief Thompson.
I had found four guys hanging out in our city and I put them before.
That's me. I love
that. I was a lot harder there. I'm going to put some underwriters' things on these guys because I know them well.
Mm-hmm.
I work with them at the county, so I know the good and bad points, and I've got all that under wraps. I've got Curtis Bryant. Curtis, how many years you have now?
I have 16 years.
16. Danny Truitt, 12 and a half, almost 13, that's out of the institute. Neil Flowers.
15.
And this is our newbie kind of sword, but you still got some under, how many you got so far?
3 years.
3 years, that's pretty strong. This is Ethan Rogers. These guys have proven themselves to me. I was lucky enough to get them. I had an opportunity to get them, and they're here now, and they're going to help us take care of Hartsville.
So it kind of works both ways, that you know kind of their flaws and they...
Well, the reason they're here is because they got something on me.
You've always worked
for him.
Yes.
Oh, that's right. Okay. And we see you a lot.
Once.
So we're excited to have y'all. Welcome home.
Yeah. We're glad to be here.
Yeah.
Most definitely.
Good. Good. You got a good team to work for, and you guys know a lot. You know what kind of a boss he is. You've already signed up.
That cost me.
That's right. Yeah, so we're definitely are glad to have you. And we hope that you really enjoy working for the city, because we think you're going to like it. Whole different world, right?
It really is.
Smaller.
Thank you, guys.
Smaller.
Appreciate it.
Yeah,
thank you. Thank you, guys. All right. Now go to work. Good work. Actually going home.
At least you didn't make one of them stay for you. I was kind of proud. That's, I know. Delegation.
Yes, sir.
Chief Burr's here too. Man, that's... Glad to have you, Chief. Glad to have you. Okay, Planning Commission annual report.
That's a written report that's in your package.
Okay, do you receive this information without objection? Dr. Ingram, now I know why you're here. I thought you were coming to give us some updates or news, but you were here for the School Choice Week proclamation? Wonderful. I promised Johnny, because he is retired from education, that he could do all things education for us as the mayor pro tem. So would you help me present this? So, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Eddie Ingram. Oh, you're taking pictures.
Oh, in that case.
Oh, okay, here you go. I'm still in my workout phase, trying to get my six pack for the summer.
Thank you.
Okay, we are proclaiming the week of January 22nd through the 28th, 2017, is School Choice Week. And one of the things we emphasize in Dalton County is we have a lot of choices with magnet programs from the elementary level all the way up to the high school level, including our day.
Absolutely. It's a pretty good program, too.
Yeah.
They're very good program. Yes. Been recognized a couple more awards. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, John. Appreciate your comment.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
I would love to stay. I've got some kids singing the cover. Anything you want to say, or you?
I just want to thank the community. I think we're stronger together. Our differences make us stronger. I believe that. I don't want to belabor a meeting. I know how long these things can be sometimes. I had one of them last night, but we had a football game to get to, so it went remarkably fast. But at any rate, I thank you so much. Sue and I love living here in Hartsville, just up the road, and it's been a very welcoming community. So thank you very much, and I promise to work as hard and as long as I'm supposed to.
Did y'all elect the chairman last night?
Yes, Mr. Morphis is our new chair.
How about that?
Ms. Maureen Thomas is vice chair, and Mr. Govan will continue as secretary. So we're intact and ready to build three schools, one of them in this area.
There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming, sir.
Thank you.
Okay.
See you now.
So the South Carolina United Teal and White Day. It's just a proclamation. Okay. So I'll give this back to you. So I just will mention, just since we have it, the South Carolina Teal and White Day recognizes cervical cancer. It's diagnosed in an estimated 12,000 women each year. And we were sent this by Mayor Benjamin from Columbia and asked to participate. Of course, we're glad to do that. So I'll give that to the clerk. And then we'll move forward. Madam Manager, anything for your update this evening?
Sure, just a couple things. those of you that know me know that I want to be like Aiken, and Aiken's coming here tomorrow to learn from us. So that was a great compliment to the city of Hartsville and all the things we've had going on. Also, the city of Inman is coming, as you know, this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. They're staying two nights in a hotel. They're bringing their department heads and the mayor and city council. You guys will meet with their council on Friday afternoon. We're still trying to confirm that location. They will be doing their strategic planning retreat here in council chambers this weekend, though. So you'll see city staff will be up here Saturday afternoon to do a presentation for them and then to meet one-on-one with the department heads that correlate to those departments. So we're excited about that. Also, the county school city dinner is the 30th at Darlington Country Club at 6 o'clock. We'll just confirm with Sharon if you're attending or not. That would be great. I noticed on the schedule there's only two planned this year. So there's one in January, one in October. So less meetings, which is always nice. But you hopefully can attend that meeting since we're only doing two. Statement of economic interest. The mayor and I had to talk about this, and luckily I found out the answer today is there's new regs this year. You have to disclose your spouse's source of income and the type of income. So for example, if they work at Thomas Hart and they're a teacher and that's their salary, but you don't have to actually put the salary down. So that's a change to the rules this year, a little bit different, but not as bad as we had thought it could be. Found that out this afternoon. Also, Mr. Newsom from Sunoco.
We still have to report our salaries?
From just here, but not your private salary, just your source,
the source
and the type. That change went into effect January 1 of this year. But those are due March 30th, I think, and they start finding you every day after that.
If you're not. And they don't, by the way, just in case you've ever gone through this, they don't send you those fines until December the 31st of the end of that year, because I had four or five of them that came in the mail, all in the same envelope for missing the reporting filing. And so Mayor Pro Tem is the one who said, oh yeah, by the way, you should close your campaign account because it's got zero time for reporting. So I had 47 cents, and that's what I was reporting, and I got three fines, I think. So, jeez.
All right.
Yes, question. In those economic interest statements, do we have to file our taxes and those?
No tax information is required on that.
I thought I saw something about that.
And it's online, so.
I didn't see that when I read through today, but I'll go.
All right. Is that it?
No.
Will
wants to come and talk to you guys about Snowball.
The King of Glass.
Nice to have
you, sir.
You can sit at this table.
Okay, sure. All right, so as you're aware, in March 2011, we put together an agreement with the city of Hartsville to accept all the recyclables. At that time, commodity prices were really good. Let me just start by saying we are very grateful that you guys take our recycling with no regard to finances, just that you feel like you're a fabric of the community. So go ahead and finish what you were saying with that free recycling program. Right. So, anyway, unfortunately, prices have gone down significantly since that arrangement took place. So we were taking the recyclables from the city at no charge to the city. Now that those prices have actually fallen down a good bit, when we take we call it the weighted average price. So it's the price of cardboard, price of plastics. We lump them together and we come up with one price. That price was somewhere in the range of $140 a ton. Today it's down to 80. So we've had to go back to a lot of our municipal contracts, talk to those guys, reduce the price. We've been successful in doing so. One thing different about our arrangement with the City of Hartsville, the City of Hartsville was very important to us. We wouldn't be accepting co-mingled recyclable in Hartsville if we were in any other city like Hartsville. We take this material, we bring it into Hartsville, we transport it to Columbia, and that's where it's sorted and processed. As you all know and can imagine, that's pretty expensive. So we've got this new arrangement. We've gone back to City of Columbia. We've gone back to Richland County. We've been successful at passing along the new arrangement to accommodate for these charges. So with that, under this new arrangement, it would be a charge that would be capped to the city at $20 per ton. The commingle that we receive from the city today from the curbside, it's about 40 tons a month. So,
what if we just pass that cost along to Richland County, or
just kind of sweep it under into their numbers?
Cost of doing business.
Yeah.
So one thing that I guess we should probably mention, since the press is here, is that glass is one of those things that is absolutely killing y'all, killing us, because it causes more work and you can't do anything with it, right? So every time you put glass in the recycling bin, the thought is you should be helping, but really you're causing more cost. So
glass is by far probably the lowest, it is the lowest commodity, the lowest value.
So if it's paying someone to take the glass.
Yes, so what we do is we take this glass from the city, we load it into a truck, we drive the truck to Columbia, we run it across our line, and then we pay somebody to take it.
What do you know what they do with it?
They're taking it back to Wilson, North Carolina.
Yeah.
That's where they're going to process it and then
make fiber out of it.
80% of it goes back into the bottle industry, and then another 20% may go into sandblasting.
Wow.
Sunoco will not tell us to take glass out of our commingled recycle. That's not something they're going to do. But the city is, we're going to make a recommendation when we get all of our new equipment in. We're going to go to every other week recycling with the large roll carts, as what other cities are doing. And then we also are going to recommend taking the glass out of the recycling at that point, because it will lower our tonnage, lower our price that we're going to have to pay Sunoco. But that's not now. You can still put glass in there. But probably in 2 or 3 months, we'll be coming to you to make a recommendation.
So the trade-off with the landfill, putting the glass in the landfill?
We don't pay the landfill, though.
You do pay. We just don't.
Well,
the city doesn't charge.
The city doesn't have a tipping fee for a residential.
You pay it in your county tax. Okay. So you have to tell your kids, break your boxes down and put them in the recycling bin, because it's going to be every 2 weeks.
Right.
Mine like to take the biggest box and shove it in there so that nothing else can go in there. Got to make it last 2 weeks now.
We're also working, there's an app that we're going to employ at this point. So it'll tell you, get a reminder what day your recycling is going to go out. If a truck breaks down, we can go in there and say, keep it out overnight because we'll pick it up tomorrow. Holiday schedule, it's going to be really neat. But there's also a sorting game where you can play, where you can decide what goes in the recycling and what doesn't. It's a little game that will be on the app. So we're pretty excited about that. You already playing the game?
Yeah. So, in all seriousness, we appreciate the partnership that Sunoco has afforded us. If Sunoco didn't care about the city of Hartsville, we wouldn't have a recycling program. Most people aren't aware of the expense of just the roll carts for the city, which is, Dana, was it $500,000 a year to get roll carts when you buy them? Is that way too high? Okay, $250,000. They're expensive.
Yeah,
$50 a piece.
Times a lot. It's a lot of money. So yeah, but we wouldn't be doing that if you guys didn't see the value in Hartsville. We appreciate that.
Thank you.
Yeah. So Mr. Newsom, on glass, I understand. What you said about that. What about the plastics and the Tetra Pak?
That's going to be something I'll need to talk to our plant in Columbia about, that just to make sure they are accepting that, but I can follow up on that.
I had the privilege of working at the Edgeport plant.
Okay.
So that's why I know what good plastic is, right? And Tetra Pak is.
Right. So you're saying the Tetra Pak, this would be the high C containers?
Yeah.
Okay. Right now, we are not designed to take Tetra Pak. While Tetra Pak is good value,
right,
when you run it across that sort line that we have bunkers dedicated to certain grades, and those bunkers are dedicated to the grades, bulk grades, like
okay,
cardboard and plastic. We don't have one dedicated for Tetra Pak.
Okay.
Just as an aside, in Horry County, they made a big deal in the Sun News this past week about this role schools play in recycling and how for the county that would reduce the amount of trash going into the landfills and things, and it's right significant there. And
I wish schools would play a bigger part in that. It makes for good citizens and good environmental policy, I think.
Teaches your kids good values.
We have a few schools that are recycling, but it's not mandated, it appears, from the district level at this point. So it's kind of just a volunteer basis.
I know, we just let Eddie go.
Yeah.
We should have him yes.
He's been in on those discussions. Yeah. It's just not been mandatory. It's not mandatory yet.
Okay.
Sunoco's willing. I mean, they've volunteered. If the schools want to get more involved, they'll send someone down to train the schools to do a presentation. So the offer is out there.
Yeah, I think what you mentioned is important. If you go back before the program started, look at the tonnage going into the landfill versus now, I think it's pretty impressive.
I think it's simply by switching from the containers that were once set at the curb and now going to the roll carts has helped a lot too. So once that container is filled, everybody stops recycling and goes into the trash. Yeah. Having that larger container.
All right, you work on getting the price of recycling commodities back up.
We'll work on that.
That's an important part of the contract, that if they do ever recover, that we'll get a rebate back at that point. So it's flexible in the contract on how that's going to work.
Yeah, and again, to go back to that weighted average price, I'm not saying take the glass out, but if you guys decide to take the glass out, it will increase your overall weighted average price because that is a negative number.
Wish we could find something constructive to do here with that so you don't have to transport it back. I had pictures of that thing in your yard that you punch your fist into the glass to get it tougher. Use that. All right. Anything else you need from us?
I don't think so.
Thank you, and please pass our thanks on to higher ups. We appreciate what Sunoco does for the city.
We appreciate the city. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
You want to take that? Okay, madam, anything else before we? Okay. Then we'll move into unfinished business. Item 6 on the agenda is public hearing and final reading of ordinance 4274. The manager will publish the ordinance.
To annex an approximately 10.44 acres of land owned by the city of Hartsville that is tax map parcel 056-04-01-048, 056-04-01-049, 056-08-01-085, located along White and Leesburg Streets into the city limits of Hartsville.
Okay, you heard the reading by title and presentation of the city manager. This time the chair will open the public hearing. If you'd like to be heard on ordinance 4274, if you'll rise, come to the front, state your name and address for the record. Please limit your comments to 2 minutes or less. Seeing that there are none, the chair will close the public hearing and entertain any motions from the floor.
Mr. Mayor, make a motion that we pass the resolution. Ordinance 4274.
There is a motion on the floor. Is there a second?
Second.
Is there any discussion on the ordinance? On the motion. Hearing none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay. Public hearing and final reading of ordinance 4274 has passed. Moving into new business, item 7 on the agenda is resolution 1-17-01, approval of a recycling agreement with Sunoco Recycling Incorporated. Is there such a motion on the floor?
Mr. Mayor, make a motion to pass resolution 01-17-01.
Is there a second?
Second.
Is there any discussion? Hearing and all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay. The resolution carries. Item 8 on the agenda, resolution 1-17-02, approval to apply for 2017 Justice Assistance Grant for the purchase of equipment for the Hartsville Police Department. Is there such a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Is there any discussion?
Yes.
Madam.
In detail, or in general, what type of equipment?
We're looking at more for the narcotics division, maybe purchasing a canine equipment for him, maybe some vehicles for narcotics and some other undercover
operative equipment. Okay. Any further questions? Okay, hearing there are none, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay. The ayes have it. Resolution 1-17-02 is passed. Item 9 on the agenda, first reading of ordinance 4280. If the manager will.
To authorize the purchase of land at tax map parcel number 056-07-01-036, located at 326 Coker Avenue, consisting of 0.75 acres from Meadows Properties Incorporated.
Okay, you've heard the reading by title and presentation, city manager. This time, the chair will entertain any motions from the floor.
Mr. Mayor, make a motion we pass ordinance 4280.
There's a motion. Is everything okay?
Okay.
Just check. There's a motion.
Second.
There's a second. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay.
Nay.
There's one abstention. I mean, no, not an abstention. Nay. One nay. The ayes have it. First reading, ordinance 4280 passed. At this time, the chair will entertain a motion to enter executive session pursuant to the South Carolina Code of Freedom of Information Act, section 30-4-70, paragraph A, subparagraph 2, for discussion of negotiations incident to proposed contractual agreements. Is there such a motion on the floor?
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed by nay. Ladies and gentlemen, we stand in executive session, and thank you for your time this evening.